In the following, I would like to present to you an example where the discounted American contingent claim is indeed a submartingale. And for that, I would like to consider, for simplicity, a financial market model which only consists of the price process of our risk-free security and the price process of one risky security. And moreover, I would like to assume that this financial market model is not only free of arbitrage, but actually it's also complete. And moreover, I would like to impose on the numerator the assumption that this is an increasing process, meaning that P almost surely S naught T is bounded from above by the value of S naught T plus 1 for any time point T in the index set 0 up to capital T minus 1. And let us now consider an American call option, and to remind you, here's the definition of it. So it's nothing else but the process which is given at every time point T by the positive part of the difference between the price process of our risky security and the strike price capital K, which we would like to assume to be strictly positive. And consider now the following random variable. So it consists of the American call option at time point T times the ratio between the numerator at time of maturity divided by the value of the numerator at time point T. And clearly, this object over here is a non-negative F capital T measurable random variable. Hence, it is a European Union contingent claim. And from a financial point of view, what you do is, at time point little t, you take the payoff of your American call option and you invest it into the numerator and keep that portfolio until the time of maturity. And under the assumption that our financial market model is complete, we then know that this particular European Union contingent claim is attainable. Hence, by theorem 2.12, we know, or we can conclude, that the discounted American contingent claim at every time point t taken from our index set is integrable with respect to the unique equivalent martingale measure q. And moreover, if we now pick two time points s and t from our index set such that s is strictly less than t, and we consider the following conditional expectation, namely the one, the conditional expectation given the equivalent with respect to this equivalent martingale measure Q of the discounted American call option at time point T given the sigma algebra Fs. Then by plugging in the definition of this American call option and bringing that positive random variable S naught T inside this positive part, I obtain first of all the value of the discounted price process X1T and the ratio between the strike price and the price of the risk-free security S naught at time point T. But since the numerator is not only increasing under this physical measure P, but also under this equivalent martingale measure Q, because P is equivalent to Q, we also know or can obtain the following lower bound to that conditional expectation simply by replacing S naught T by S naught S. And in a second step, I would like to apply Jensen's inequality to the function of this positive part. So by bringing that out of the conditional expectation and taking advantage of the fact that the discounted price process is a martingale under this equivalent martingale measure Q, we end up with the following expression, namely, on the one, the positive part of X1S minus the ratio k divided by s naught s. And here we took advantage of the fact that that is an fs measurable random variable, which we can take out from the condition expectation. But this is nothing else but the definition of the discounted American call option at time point s, which clearly shows that the discounted American call option is a submartingale under Q. And due to the fact that this financial market model is complete, we know by the previous corollary that the European contingent claim, where we evaluate this American one at time point capital T, is attainable. Hence, we conclude that also this American call option is attainable in that particular situation. And this brings us clearly to the question, how attainability of American contingent claims are related with the attainability of European contingent claims in general. Meaning, is it true that when every American contingent claim is attainable, that the underlying financial market model is complete? Or vice versa, if we know that the financial market model is complete, does that imply that every American contingent claim is attainable? So let us first focus on that question. And the answer is given by the following theorem. So here I consider a financial market model which consists as usual of the price process of our risk-free security and the d-dimensional vector of the price process of this d risky securities. And I assume that this financial market model is free of arbitrage. And moreover, I assume that in this financial market model, every American contingent claim is attainable. And then the statement is that indeed the underlying financial market model is then complete. So in order to prove that theorem, we have to show that every European contingent claim is indeed attainable. So to do that, let us consider an arbitrary European contingent claim. So in the first step, we should come up with a suitable American contingent claim. And here we proceed as in example 4.1. We simply define the process CAT by setting that random variable equal to 0 for all time points t from 0 up to capital T minus 1. And the value at time point capital T is simply given by the value of our European contingent claim. And since by assumption every, so this gives clearly rise to an adapted non-negative process, hence an American contingent claim. Moreover, we know by the theorem 4.4a that this corresponding discounted American contingent claim is integrable for any time point t in our index set with respect to this equivalent martingale measure Q. And now let us fix two time points S and T taken from our index set I, such that S is strictly less than T. And I fix an equivalent martingale measure Q. And then let me consider the following conditional expectation under this measure Q. Namely, I consider this discounted American contingent claim, which we here constructed, at time point T. And I condition on the sigma algebra Fs. Now you see that random variable by construction is 0 for all time points t, which is strictly less than capital T. And at the time point capital T, that value is then given here by the value of the European contingent claim. So I can write that conditional expectation also in the following form. So that's the conditional expectation under this measure Q of this discounted American contingent claim at time point capital T, given the sigma algebra Fs, times the indicator function that little t is equal to capital T. So by definition, I can replace that random variable CA of capital T by simply the value of our European contingent claim with which we started with. And so we end up with that conditional expectation. And now we can take advantage of the fact that that is a non-negative random variable. So simply by bounding that quantity from below by zero and using the monotonicity of the conditional expectation, we obtain the following lower bound, namely, which is lower bound zero, a trivial one. But notice that this parameter s here, since it is strictly less than t, and t could be in the worst case only capital T, this means that s is strictly less than capital T, we know that this value 0 equals the value of the discounted American contingent claim, which we here constructed. Hence, we see here clearly that as the discounted American contingent claim is a submartingale. So, and by assumption, we know that this American contingent claim is attainable. Hence, this previous corollary 4.4 implies that the European call option CA capital T, which is equal to CE, is attainable. And this shows then that the financial market model by definition is complete. So what about the other direction? So is it true that if the underlying financial market model is complete, that every American contingent claim is attainable? So, and the answer is given the following theorem. So again, the setting is similar. I consider my favorite financial market model as bar, and I assume that this is an arbitrage-free financial market model. And moreover, I assume that this financial market model is complete. And then the statement is that indeed every American contingent claim is in that particular situation attainable. So how to prove that statement? So let us pick an arbitrary American contingent claim C. So since our financial market model is free of arbitrage, we first of all know that the set of all equivalent martingale measure is non-empty. And moreover, we know that this random variable Ct divided by S naught t multiplied by S naught capital T is clearly a non-negative F capital T measurable random variable, hence a European contingent claim. So as in the previous example, by theorem 2.12, we know that that random variable is, so the discounted European contingent claim is integrable with respect to the equivalent martingale measure, or with respect to a equivalent martingale measure Q. So first of all, we know the integrability of the discounted American contingent claim at every time point T taken from our index set. And this also holds true for every equivalent martingale measure Q. Hence, we can now start to construct the corresponding Snell envelope for our discounted American contingent claim with respect to a given measure Q taken from our set of all equivalent martingale measures. So, and by the theorem 4.1a, we know that the Snell envelope is a super martingale under this measure Q. So we can use now Dupe's decomposition to write that super martingale as the initial value, that naught, plus a martingale plot, plus this predictable process. So here M, as I said, is a martingale under Q, and it starts at time point 0 in 0. This process A is a predictable process, and due to the fact that we start here with a super martingale, we know that this predictable process is decreasing, and again it starts at time point 0 in 0. So what do we have to show now? So we have to come up with a self-financing trading strategy such that the discounted value process with respect to the choice or the choice of our trading strategy dominates the discounted American contingent claim Q almost surely for any time point T in our index head. And moreover, we have also to construct a stopping time such that equality holds true. So let us first address the question how to come up with a self-financing trading strategy such that the discounted value process dominates the discounted American contingent claim. And here we take advantage of the theorem 2.17, which tells us that in a complete financial market model, we can represent every martingale in terms of a discrete stochastic integral. So, meaning there exists a d-dimensional predictable process H, and we simply set here H not equal to X1 to simplify notation, such that the martingale MT can be written as the initial value M0 plus the discrete stochastic integral between H and the discounted price process. And here you clearly see, since that value is equal to zero, that integral is nothing else but the discounted gain process at time point T. Moreover, by lemma 2.3, we know that once we have given such a process H, we can construct a predictable process H not in such a way that the resulting process H bar, consisting of this process H not and H, the process H which we have constructed here, such that this process H bar is a self-financing trading strategy, and we also have the freedom to choose the initial value of our discounted value process. And I would like to show that, V H bar of not is equal to that not, the value of our Snell envelope at time point zero. And here I take advantage of the fact that our filtration or that sigma algebra F not is trivial, meaning it's only consisting of the empty set and the full space, which implies that this random variable Z not is deterministic. So then I can now apply lemma 2.2c, which allows me to decompose the discounted value process at time point t into the discounted value processes time point zero plus the gain process at time point t. But by definition, the gain process is nothing else but the martingale at time point t. And since this predictable process A is decreasing and it starts at time point zero in zero, I know that AT is non-positive for every time point t. So this implies that if I now add that term over here, I get a lower bound. But you see, by Dupe's decomposition, that term over here is equal to the value of the Snell envelope at time point t. And by construction of the Snell envelope, we know that that process dominates the discounted American contingent claim for every time point t, Q almost surely. Hence, we have checked that we have constructed here a self-financing trading strategy such that the discounted value process dominates the discounted American contingent claim for every time point T taken from our index set. So let us come now to the second point in the construction of a hedging strategy. Namely, we should come up with a stopping time tau star taken from our set of all admissible stopping times, meaning of the set of all stopping times which are bounded from above by capital T. And we should construct that stopping time in such a way that the discounted value process with respect to the self-financing trading strategy which we constructed here at that time point tau star coincides with the value of the discounted American contingent claim at that particular chosen time point. And in view of theorem 4.1, it is clear that we should define tau star as the first time point in our index set where the Snell envelope coincides with the discounted American contingent claim. So that object over here we have seen in theorem 4.1b, that it is indeed stopping time, which is bounded from above by capital T. Hence, we can now apply Dupe's optional stopping theorem, which first of all tells us that the Snell envelope, which is originally a super martingale, that this implies also that the stopped Snell envelope is a super martingale. So, and by applying the Dupe decomposition to that stopped super martingale and using the fact that the Dupe decomposition is Q almost truly unique, we end up with the following expression, namely that the Dupe decomposition of this stopped super martingale coincides with the Dupe decomposition of the super martingale that when we plug in simply these random times T minimum tau star. So we have the following representation that the stop process at time point T is the same by definition as the Snell envelope at that random time T minimum tau star, which can be decomposed into this initial value Z naught, into the martingale evaluated at that stopping time and that predictable process evaluated at that stopping time, and this martingale and this predictable process are the same, which we considered over here. So we ended up with that decomposition, and by definition that is nothing else but the stopped martingale, and this is nothing else but the stopped predictable process. So what does it bring us? Well, remember that by theorem 4.1b, the stopped Snell envelope is indeed a martingale. So if we know that this process over here is a martingale, so this simply should mean that this stopped predictable process should be equal to zero for every time point t taken from our index set. So in particular, we know that that process a t minimum tau star is equal to zero for all time point t from our index set Q almost surely, which indeed implies that a of t star is equal to zero Q almost surely. Why is that the case? Simply plug in capital T at that place and using the fact that tau star is bounded is less than or equal to capital T, meaning this minimum is attained at tau star. So what do we conclude from that? Well, we then conclude that on the one hand, we know that our discounted value process is simply equal to the Snell envelope, that we have the following representation now of our discounted value process at that particular time tau star, namely it's nothing else but that naught plus this martingale part m of tau star. So that's the same as this value z of tau star, but this we know by construction, so by the choice of our stopping time, that this coincides with the value of the discounted American contingent claim at that stopping time. Hence, we checked both conditions for an hedging strategy, and this simply proves that the American contingent claim indeed is attainable. So here's a couple of remarks. So it turns out that this value Z naught is somehow the minimal amount of money which we need from a seller's perspective to construct a hedging strategy for the American contingent claim which we provide. On the other hand, this random variable tau star is an optimal exercise strategy from the perspective of the buyer. And in particular, we know by theorem 4.3 that the value of this optimal stopping time, so indeed that's an optimal stopping time, the value of this optimal stopping time, meaning the expectation under Q of this discounted American contingent claim evaluated at tau star, coincides with this value that not. And this will be important in the next lecture, where we address the question of how to price fairly an American contingent claim.